Now, I want you to listen to what I'm going to say, Collins, because I'm going to lay it on the line. And furthermore, I'm going to ask questions later. Now, I don't want you to drop dead of surprise, but I am not the man who owns this newspaper, not even that much of it. So basically, I don't give two hoots in hell whether we sell 3 copies or 300,000 copies, except that if we don't sell 300,000 copies, then I have no job, and furthermore, you have no job. And because of the conditions that prevail, Collins, long before I have no job, you will have become such a stranger to this city room that if we had dogs here, they'd bark at you, Collins.
Okay, Mr. Bathgate, I'm willing to admit it. I made a mistake.
You are? Really? Well, you've certainly got character, boy. Not much intelligence, perhaps, or any instinct for newspaper work, but character you've got up to here.
Mr. Bathgate, when I first started on this paper, we were told that the most important thing they'd look for in this was initiative.
I don't give a damn what they told you, Dayside. You're working the night edition now, 3 to 12 midnight.
Yes, sir, but you gotta admit, sir, if it had turned out to be legit, I could have won the Pulitzer Prize for a story like that.
Oh, well, there's always next year, you know. Now, Collins, where were your brains that night? Some itinerant crackpot gypsy wanders in, shows you a crumpled piece of cheap wrapping paper covered with a lot of lines and some childish high school equations on it. Tells you that it's the top secret plan for America's first manned space station. And how did you react? You not only didn't throw him out on his ear, you actually believed him. And then you assured him that this paper would buy his phony claptrap for some ridiculous fancy sum.
He didn't look like a gypsy to me, Mr. Bathgate.
Why? Because his ears weren't pierced? Oh, Collins, one of these days you're going to end up famous for owning more non-producing oil wells than anyone ever before you or since you.
Well, I don't see what oil wells have to do with space stations.
Get out. Just a minute, Collins.
Yes, sir, Mr. Bathgate.
I don't want you to even talk to me for 1 week, Collins. And by that, I mean I don't want to have any kind of communication with you whatsoever. If we should happen to meet each other on the way to the... Don't you even dare nod to me. Do you understand? That's an order, Collins. Now get back to work.